I got a new setup.
Let's dive right in.
Ooh. Myself a proper YouTube setup. Today we're going over my last journey before quarantine. This was just before quarantine was mandated, so you'll see a few people wandering about, but not that many. We went to some kind of remote spots. So I'm scrolling through my Instagram feed and I come across a guy named Nick, member of our photo group, digging through his photos and found one from up on Mount Arrowsmith. I told him it'd been a while since I'd been out there, and he offered to take me up. 2 days later, I'm standing at the base of the mountain. Made a couple of stops at some different hiking spots along the way, which is where I grabbed most of this footage. Unfortunately, I didn't get a whole lot up on the mountain, because unfortunately the conditions weren't great, and none of my equipment is properly weather sealed, so got a couple of photos up there, not a whole lot of video. So this'll have to suffice. This trip was a little bit out of my comfort zone compared to a lot of the stuff that I've been doing recently. Most of the time I'm doing kind of your urban, underground, street photography, as well as some fancy portraits. So trying to do a hard switch into landscape and crazy hiking was a pretty big change. But I definitely got some sweet shots out there and found a couple of new spots. Let's dive in.
Living in the moment.
I had a little bit more behind the scenes to show you guys, but unfortunately, it's kind of difficult to man two cameras at once when you're on a hike. So you're stuck with me doing a voiceover. And if I look super tired while recording this, it's because it's 1 a.m. That's the only time I can record, is when no one else is up. But let's take a closer look at some of these images. Now this first one here is definitely one of my favorites. Doing these low angle, kind of soft focus portraits is something that I don't do that often, but I really love. Ever since I got this shot a couple years ago on another hiking trip. Now if you take a really close look at this image, I didn't actually focus on his face. I focused on his hand. And you get a little bit of that halo at the top of the frame, which is something that you get with these older lenses. Now something you guys might not know is that I shoot everything with vintage glass. I literally don't own a native lens for Sony. Hell, right now I'm shooting on a 17mm Super Takumar. This thing hasn't been made since the 70s. And this shot was taken using my Super Takumar 50mm f1.4. And yes, before I get it down in the comments, this lens is slightly radioactive due to the thoriated glass element on the rear, giving it a slight yellow tint. Now unfortunately, lenses like this and a lot of the older Carl Zeiss lenses cannot be reproduced due to some of the materials that they used, like thorium or lead, that was used to coat the glass to prevent fungal growth or chromatic aberration, as well as to help improve the sharpness by not having to use a crazy amount of other coatings to fix other issues. So unfortunately, lenses like these can't be made anymore. Granted, most of those issues have been corrected with modern glass, but in my opinion, they've been corrected a bit too much. Now, on to the next one. This image again was shot on the 50mm f1.4, but I did stop it down a little bit to about f2 so I could get a little bit more sharpness in the subject, especially considering I'm using this bad boy, a Sony A7R Mark III, a full-frame 42-megapixel sensor, and this thing is an absolute beast. But I'll get into that some other time. Again, I wish I had some more behind-the-scenes footage, but it just didn't happen. But this area was absolutely beautiful. Moss and rocks everywhere. And I saw this comp as we were coming around the corner. So this spot was absolutely beautiful. The moss, the trees, the rocks, everything just had those beautiful tones that you're looking for forest photos. Now, I lined him up as he was going around the corner. For these shots of him walking here, I didn't get him to stop. I just held back a little bit so I could line up the shot as we were still going along the hike. Same thing with this next shot. This was right after he walked around the corner, and it was still a fantastic composition, so I knew I just had to grab it. This shot was pretty tricky, because I was already lining up a shot with him staring off into the distance like a typical Instagram, and then without warning he started bolting back towards me. Even though I was shooting on a fairly wide lens with a fairly deep depth of field, I believe I was shooting around f8. Given the resolution of this camera, I really wanted to get that tack sharp focus, and grabbing him while he was running was pretty difficult. Nick brought us out to a crazy rock formation, and I wish I'd grabbed more footage there, but unfortunately I was a little preoccupied climbing the thing. This shot again was on the 28mm, and I believe I was around f5.6. There was a couple other spots around the rock that had some way crazier formations, but this one definitely had the most pleasing light and allowed me to get a really nice environmental portrait. And it's definitely one of my favorites from the trip. Now we can't end off without talking about this shot. This was unfortunately one of the few photos I was able to grab while we were up on Mount Arrowsmith. This was about halfway up the mountain, believe it or not, and we're already at around 2,000 to 3,000 feet elevation. Me, being incredibly smart, decided I was going to bring three cameras and a full set of lenses up a 7,000 foot mountain. Especially since I hadn't hiked that mountain in over 2 years. The last time I did this hike was in the middle of summer, so I was pretty surprised when he brought out the snowshoes. We got this shot about halfway up the mountain, and it's definitely a memory to be saved. But it was also very difficult for me to edit this photo, because you have a lot of fall off from the snowstorm that was happening. This was just during a break in the snow, so you still have that haze in the background. But everything was super bright, and trying to keep
the mountain, which was the real focus of the image, as well as having a subject in the foreground, trying to balance that out in the edit was pretty difficult. But I think I pulled it out all right. Let me know if you guys think you could do a better job of this down in the comments. All right, I think that's it for this video. I'll see you guys in the next one.
Peace!